living on the top. Penthouse suites looking down on the op. Took her for a test drive, left them on the lot. Time is money, so I spend it on a watch. Hold on, no titties showing through the white tee. You can see the thong busting on my tight jeans. Okay, rocks on my fingers like a nigga wife me. Got another shorty, she ain't nothing like me. Yeah, about to catch another fight. Yeah, the apple bottom make him wanna bite.
I just wanna have a good night.
I just wanna have a good night.
Hold up.
If you don't know, now you know. If you don't, you gotta let him go. You could have anybody, any money, no. Cause when you a boss, you could do what you want. Have a good night.
Hold up. Hold up. Hold up. Hold up.
Yo, what is goody, ladies and gentlemen? We are back. We are back for another week of shit. Yo, this week was a pretty big week. It's a pretty big week. We got 10 pickups. Before I get to the 10 pickups, I did a Wakanda Forever review. I'm going to post that on Thursday. I'm going to post it on Thursday. The Wakanda Forever review. I'm posting on Thursday. Just cause. And because I want this video to get traction, because I'm posting this. Would be today, Monday. I'm technically Sunday, but I'm posting it tomorrow, which is Monday for ya, which is today. Confusing. So Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, it's just this video is the importance. And then Thursday, on to next week, is the Wakanda Forever video. But yeah, that's what I want to get out of the way. Let's get straight into it. So it's 10 issues, but out of these 10 issues, three of them I have not read. There's just a lot going on, and three of them I haven't read. But I'll add these three to the review for next week. The three that I haven't read yet, I can give you like a cover review, I guess. So, because that's what I wanted to talk about. So, Invincible Iron Man, number 3. Fam, look at this cover. This cover is insane. Oof. I love it. And then Alex Cross never misses with these Fantastic Four covers. Bro, there's variants that are good, but yo, these Alex, bro. I can't just look at how gorgeous this shit is. Holy fuck, and he's old. He is so old. He is so old. Bro, Marvel's having this weird thing. I don't know why. But they're having Mad Planet of the Apes variant covers. OG Planet of the Apes. Look at this Spider-Man one. This shit is so dope. This shit is so crazy cool. But yeah, there's gonna be like... There's other ones that I wanted to cop, but I'm like... I'm not even reading those issues. For me to cop them just because they got... Like, when I cop the Spawn variants. Also, there is a Spawn variant. I thought Old Dog was the last Spawn variant. No. There's one more Spawn variant left. And it's in here. I got the last one. So, yeah. I'm loving the Planet of the Apes. But since I don't really read... I have to pick up Marvel, but... I have to pick up Marvel, but it's just like, I have to find something. Like, so these three right now are part of my Marvel runs. I think I have like two other ones. So, but I need a variant because out of Marvel, there's one, two, three, I think like three or four of them are just Spider-Man spinoffs. Besides the Amazing Spider-Man run, there's two or three that are just Spider-Man spinoffs. I think I should expand my Marvel, like, so, my Marvel Horizon, which I am, because I got Fantastic Four and Iron Man, so, there's that. So let's get into the next issue. I'm trying to just read the names here of the authors. So sorry about that. All right. Issue number 7 that makes top 7 this week is called Betty. The Chilling Adventures of Betty, Final Girl, One Shot. As in Betty Cooper, from Archie Comics. Yo, so there's like this like art, it's called Archie Horror, and it's just like mad different hard Archie stories. But it's not always just about Archie. Like this one was about Betty Cooper, and I thought this was cute. It's like her trying to like babysit like I think Veronica's cousin, Veronica's little cousin, and so she's watching a scary movie, and there's like as she's watching the movie, different horror stories are being told, and at the end she's like, "Oh my God." And Veronica finally comes back. Veronica's like, "Oh, thank you for watching my cousin, blah blah blah." And because Betty dreamed that she was fighting some demon thing, so Veronica's like, "Okay." And then Betty walks off, and she hears somebody at the door, and it's Betty. Veronica's like, "If you're Betty, then who's?" And then it ends. It's so cute. Also, Betty looked juicy. Okay. I'd give that one a 7. It was good. I thought it was dope. It was cutesy. Mark Miller and Jorge Jimenez's Nemesis Reloaded. This series is actually really good. I wouldn't say really, it's good. I would say really good. It's good. I thought issue one was better than this issue. But Jorge Jimenez, oh my God. This guy is a god with with drawing. The way these interiors look are just simply amazing to me. Like, holy fuck. The detail that he puts in this is just so good. The detail is so good. The story, we're getting a little bit more backstory of Nemesis and where he's like coming from, how he started. This is him, if you did not know, as a little kid. His parents were like shitheads, and he just was gonna be like a little, like a vagabond street rat. He was trying to rob some lady's purse. The lady caught him and was like, "I'm gonna teach you how to really live in the streets and hustle." And he's like, "Aye, lady." And so he's like in this demonic cult thing, and they force him to fight to the death some other little kid, and he does. He almost kills the kid. I think they stop him before he kills the kid, and then so it's like a training montage, while he also has the city, LA, almost the city of LA. Might as well have it under, under ransom because he's offering 10K for every badge brought to him, a police badge, because he's trying to get. Kill all the cops. And it's so he has a bounty on all the police. He already killed the last police commissioner in the last issue. So this issue, since it was more like backstory and stuff, I'm not saying it was bad, just the first issue came off strong. Can't wait to see more of this. I'm actually really interested in Nemesis Reloaded. I'd give this issue, the first issue I gave an 8. Should I give a 7? 7.5. Let me see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yep, number 6 of the week. Moseley. By Rob Gilroy. I hope I'm saying his name right. I feel like I be botching names sometimes. And Sam Lofty. The interiors. Bro. It's like a guy who hates AI. It's like kind of like iRobot. How Will Smith's character hated it, but what it and you know how Will Smith's arm was like machine, but in this world, the god like the machines are so sentient, they're like almost gods, and they give him abilities to fight off the machines. This one we kind of got a little bit more backstory into his daughter, like entering a school that teaches more engineering with AI and all that. A little bit, we get to see a little bit of hatred. We get to see because there's the city he lives in is like completely AI and all that, and electric and technology. People are cyborgs, whatever. He destroys one of the god machines, and people get disconnected, so he unplugs them. And you would think that he was doing people a favor. They hated him. He starts getting chased down. He was about to kill all of them until the gods like took his power and were like, "No, you gotta fucking leave." So he leaves the city and goes to like. For the first time in years, and he's like beaten up, about to pass out, and he goes to like this almost it's like The Walking Dead, where Alexandria and Walking Dead, that little town where everything the walls are made out of fucking like sheet metal and wood and whatever, And he goes there, they open the gate, and it's his fucking wife. And it's like, so she's been living there the whole time, because she doesn't live in the city. So, I think this one, I'd give it like an 8 as well. 7.5, 8, around there. I love the first issue. The second issue was good. Not as good as the first, because again, the first one, just like Nemesis, came off strong. I liked it, though. I can't wait to see more of it. That was really good, though. Nightclub, bro, Mark Miller. I have like 3 different Mark Miller issues that I'm reading at the moment. Mark Miller and Juanan Ramirez. Mark Miller likes working with Spanish artists. I love it, though. This cover is so dope. This shit is fire. Vampires meets Sons of Anarchy. This kid and his friends are like the vampires now, but they're trying to still like live the teenage life. But this time you get to see them be more superheroes in issue 3. What is it? It's like Star Guy and Goldbird. Like, they have so stupid names. But they try to stop like these drug dealers, and they again, just because you have superpowers doesn't make you invincible. You have to have brains at the end of the day. They open this drug dealer's thing, but they're vampires. You have to be invited in, so they can't even stop the drug dealers. And one of them pops him in the dome, and yeah, he doesn't die because it'll just heal, but it has to heal. So he's just on the floor, and he's just like, because his brain got blasted in, so it's like healing, and he's telling his friends, go stop him or whatever. And then it jumps to like this gang. Like this weird motorcycle gang breaking into this home and attacking this family. They kill the dad. They kill the fucking one of the kids. They kill the mom. And one of the little daughters is hiding under the table. They grab her and they're carrying like this casket, which has like this old decrepit person in there. And it's like an old vampire that looks like it's been dried out from blood. Got him there. Got that person in there as well. And then they're looking at their phone and they see, because these idiots, the kids, are posting vlogs on YouTube of them being superheroes, but them turning into bats and morphing back. So these other vampires are seeing them, and they show their leader. The biker gang shows the leader. The leader is the guy who turned the kid from issue 1, and he's like, what the fuck? So the leader, who we thought was good recruiting to start an army, is actually part of a gang of shitheads. This issue, though, it was really good. I gave it an 8. Solid 8. Better than issue 2. I give it an 8. Now we're in the top 3 issues. Top 3 issues. This issue was wild. Lovesick number 4. This issue was just maddening. Luana, I feel like I fuck up her name every time. Luana Vecchio. I feel like I fuck it up every time. Anyways, Luana did this lovesick. This cover is lit as fuck, though. Domino is insane. So, we get to know Domino's backstory. She was part of, like, these people who were trying to get in a red room, trying to be part of this dominatrix thing, who gets beaten, tortured, and then essentially gets killed. We find out the people she's doing this shit for are all cannibals. Rich prick cannibals. And the main dude who, when she was not a little girl, but like a teenager, he was this guy who found her on a chat, and basically, he takes these people in, treats them as pets, has them on a collar and everything, beats them and whatever, and then eventually he kills them and eats them. But he didn't do that to her. He gave her a chance because he saw something else in her, and that's when the persona Domino came into place. And he tries to invite her to this like party that he's throwing. She's like, nah, because she's beaten up. She still got the eye patch because her eye got fucked. And they go to the party, and it's just a bunch of rich people who So she runs the Red Room and grabs these people to get killed, and basically she's kidnapping people to get put online for them, 'cause the bodies get given to these rich dudes for them to eat, and they're not even dead. They're still on the fucking table, getting cut open, legs ripped, cut off, and they're just eating them. And it's just like, what? She doesn't even eat them. And I'm just like, what the fuck? And the dude who's running the show, he has like two pets, one girl and one boy, and he has them on a leash. And Domino finally gets like over it, and one of the dudes starts crawling. One of the dudes recognizes Domino. He's like, just kill me. Domino gets pissed and just takes like I think it was like a fire extinguisher or something, and starts go to town on his dome, just caves his skull in. And you're just reading it and you're like, what the fuck? Okay. And then she leaves. The guy goes after her, but she cleans herself up and she's gonna stay with the guy. The guy goes, takes a shower. She gets up and she tells the two his two pets that are like this girl and the guy, they're in the cage. She's like, he's just gonna do the same to you. He's not gonna eat you. He's gonna abandon you. He's making you promises that he's not gonna complete. Blah blah blah. And then he comes out the shower. She fucking killed them. She slit their throat open and their stomachs open and let their intestines and everything pour out. Her and the guy get into it, slams her on the bed, and then they start to fuck. And she runs out into the rain, like just crying and everything, and the issue ends. I don't know where she's going with this, and I'm excited that I don't know where Luana's going with this, but Domino, it feels like, I don't know if we're gonna get a redemption story. I feel like everyone's so sick in the head that everyone has to die. Because it's like, it's evil. It's definitely evil. So everyone has to die at some point. But Domino and her little gang of bitches can get like, I don't know if they can get redeemed, but something gotta give. Because if there's like a if she goes for a redemption thing, even if she was redeemed, she has to die. Like, I don't know. But I gave this issue an 8.5. It was wild. Yo, so for issue number top number two this week is a number one issue by Tom Breyfogle. I hope I said his name right. Breyfogle. I hope I said it right, Tom. It's called How I Became a Shoplifter: The Final Generation Before Technology Took Over. Issue one. First of all, this cover is wild. I love it. I love the other variants, but I wanted to get cover A for this. So it's about a kid and his friend, and it's just their life, just like, and it starts off like in years. So they're like, I think 14 or like 11 for chapter one. And then chapter two, it's another year. Chapter three, it's another year. And it's just cool because we get to see them progress. The first chapter is them trying to get revenge on the main character's brother because the brother beat the shit out of him. So they get revenge by buying like porno mags, a Chucky doll, beer, all this other shit, and they put it in his room and make it look like he's like doing a satanic ritual. So he calls his parents. And that's how chapter one, and that was chapter one. Chapter two, they're trying to get girls. Chapter three, they're trying to redeem themselves from when they made a fool of them when they were trying to get the girls. But I just thought it was so well written, and I love how each chapter was like a different artist. I love the coloring, I love the storytelling. I love that it was nothing felt, even though because the issue's like thick, but not so thick. The interiors and everything, and it takes place like in the 90s, so I love that as well. But I love that nothing felt rushed, that each chapter was probably like 3 or 4 pages, but it was really good. A story was getting told in that little short time, because overall it's a bigger story. Because each chapter is connected. It's not like an anthology where it's like a different, no, it's the same characters, just it's like a time, each chapter is a 1 year time jump. And it was really good. I loved it. And it's just different. Again, I love when things are different from your normal superhero DC Marvel mashup crap. And I just love comics that are like different and not just superhero shit. There's no villain or no, it's just a story getting told, whether it's funny, whether it's scary, whether it's just drama, love story, it doesn't matter. I just loved it. Thought it was amazing. So yeah, I'm giving that one a 9, honestly. A 9. This issue is a 9. Please pick it up. I can't wait for issue 2. Issue 1, pick up 1. Sorry for that. My mic died, but we're back up. Anyway, so issue 1. I mean, my top pick for the week. It's been a pick that I've been waiting since December. Well, I know why since December, because this issue is the Spawn variant. They should have came out in December, but it didn't. It's 8 Billion Genies, issue 7, by Charles Soule and Ryan fucking Brown. Do you see this variant cover, bro? This is wicked. This is mad. Oh my god, and issue 7 was just a lot. It was a lot. But it was so fucking beautiful. Oh my god, there was just a lot happening. Because it went 8 years into the future. 8 decades almost, right? And there's so much time jumps in it. Because we start off with the Idea Man, who we thought was going to be this huge dude. So, Sun Man, his father fucking passes away. And because his mom was a remnant, his mom was a wish. His mom immediately goes to him, because she knows she doesn't have that much time. She's going to disappear. She tells him, you have to not trust Idea Man. You're better than this, blah, blah, blah. And mom disappears, and he's just like, what? And then the Asian, remember the Asian couple with the daughter? They find a new, like, utopia, a new place. It's called the Futuro. And in that place, kids cannot use their wish until they're 25, as long as they live there. So the baby starts to grow up. She's like 14. And then more years pass, 18. And they decide, no, this is not fair. We don't want this. We want to leave. We want to, like, we're tired of keep having our wishes. But while this is happening, there's a war between communities. The Idea Man is waging war against this community. And the Idea Man is using all their wishes. Both communities are using all their wishes to stop this, to stop this, to have this war. So, like, this huge battle's going on, and when she goes by Betty, the daughter, when the Asian daughter, when she finally leaves, the war starts happening, she runs back. Bro, her father put up a valiant fight, because, again, even though he's old, he still has the wish that he hit with the armor, but he can only do so much, bro. He was getting everything thrown at him. Her parents died, and then the Idea Man was gonna try to lie to Betty and Betty's boyfriend, like, oh, you can come to me, but Sun Man saw, was there. Sun Man was like, nah, no, no, no. Sun Man is like this huge, brolic, super-powered beast. Remember, he was the kid who wished to protect his parents and became a superhero. Sun Man was like, no, I'm not gonna let you brainwash another kid. He grabs Idea Man. And Idea Man is like, Idea Man down to his last wish, by the way. And he's like, nah, you can't tell me what to do, blah, blah, blah. I'll use my wish, but Sun Man is not stupid, because he's not a kid anymore. He's like, you're down to your last wish. Are you going to waste your wish on me to try to stop me? If you do that, then you're fucked. You better make it a good one, because then everyone else is going to come after you. And Idea Man is like, Sun Man is like, you know what? Fuck this. Tosses him out the planet. And right when Idea Man is trying to make a wish, he's out of the atmosphere, he chokes and dies, and his genie's like, okay, bye, and his genie dips, because he's dead, he dies. And it's like, we thought Idea Man was gonna be this big thing, this big bad villain, which he was. But he dies so fast. But it wasn't like a so fast, like, wow, you guys just did that, like, that's trash. No, it was like well just. Like everything was, it was, because, and then, so Idea Man, I'm assuming then, he becomes the leader of everybody. He becomes the guy in charge, but he's good. He leads for a while. Then, another time jump of decades past, Betty's an old lady. Idea Man passes, Idea Man, Sun Man finally passes away, because he's so old, he passes away. They have a funeral for him and everything, a monument, and Betty's just like, again, they lived in the futuro, and they've lived here for years, and she still has her one genie, and she's just like, I want to venture out to see the world, and so she leaves. The issue ends with her leaving. She's like an old lady. She has grandkids and everything. And so she's like, all right, I'm going to leave. And so she leaves. And when she leaves, bro, the bottom says next issue, issue 8, 800 years in the future. What? Who still has a genie in 800 years? What is happening? But bro, like, I can't even, like, fathom. I can't wait when this comes out in a thick volume, because I think I might cop. It's just going to be so good. I cannot wait, because holy shit. Like, it's just, this issue was, it was just, because me and my boys, we talk about it, we all read 8 Billion Genies, and the first things I can say was, this was just beautiful. It was beautiful. It was just gorgeous. It was saddening, but it was just a lovely issue. I thought, this is probably one of the best series I've read in a long time, in years. I might put 8 Billion Genies on my top 5 of best series runs that I've read, because this was just so, so well done. I don't want to say yet until I see issue 8, but honestly, from issue 1 through 7, there hasn't been a bad one. Let's say issue 4 was better than issue 5. Like, issue 4 was fucking amazing, and 5 was just not as amazing, but it was still amazing. Like, oh my god. Yeah, this gets a 9.5. A 9.5. Holy shit. Such a great issue. Like, but yeah, that's my pickup of the week, and that's the pick. I'm going to tell you what I got next week. Next week I think I got another 10 bomb. Oh, no, we got seven. We got Lovesick number 5. This Lovesick came in late. That's why we have Lovesick 2 weeks back to back. Batman, One Bad Day, Clayface. Amazing Spider-Man number 20. So I have to read this one, and then I'm going to read the next one, and then I'll hit you with the reviews for both of those. Damn Them All number 5. Superman. From this whole new revamp, new DC future, Superman number 1. I can't wait for that. I hope they do Superman justice. Mighty Morphin Power Rangers and Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles number 2. Yeah. Right? No, it's number 3. Number 3. Yikes. Nightwing Volume 4 number 101. Cover A. I'm getting the cover A. Those are my 7 issues. That's what I'm picking up for next week. This is the shit of this week. Oh my god, bro. There was just so much goodness in all this, bro. There was so much goodness. I fucking love it here. I love being a nerd. I need y'all to pick up comics. Drop a like. Drop a sub. Click the subscribe button. Share it if you can. Come on. You eat, we all eat. Let's do this. And that's the shit of the week. That's my pickup of the week. And I will see you next week.
promise, down on the promise, down on the promise. Money, so I spent it on a down on a what? Down.